Oh, it's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. Won't you be mine? Isn't that how it goes, Mr. Rogers' neighborhood? Wow, it is close to spring and we are out of time. We gotta get these orders out. Let's make this happen. It's only like 10 a.m. and look at how many UPS boxes we already have to go out. It's insane! We got Michael over here that came back from spring break a little early. So we're a little thankful for that, or a lot thankful for that. We got Weston over here cleaning funnels. Mm-hmm. Fun times.
Yeah.
That's quite a process.
A lot faster than it used to be though.
Yeah. Here's what they look like before they get phosphated.
On it
and we need to get it off, but scrubbing it doesn't work,
so we use this machine which uses acid on this brush and electric currents go through it, chemistry happens, and then it takes off the marks. It takes a while though.
So you just paint it with a brush and try to rinse it off, right?
It's not only chemical but sparks. Hopefully no flames. All right, keep up the good work.
And that thing is loud.
So we got Marvin over here finishing the gauge wheels that we started yesterday. And you can see that we're on the 3-inch now. Looks really nice.
This one's from Needhamag, the tire. And then we bought the rims and the bolts, the hardware and things like that from various sources so we could put together solid wheels. Why solid wheels? Why not spoke wheels? Well, this guy can't have spoked mud wheels or gauge wheels because he runs in stocks that have like long, pointy, unbreaking stocks that jam in your wheels, like sunflower stocks or certain length corn stocks. And that's a big problem. So solid wheels are the way to go. The hub area does not hold up as good as our cast spoke wheels, but it's got a urethane tire on here and he can just change out the rims and the bearing every couple years or every so many acres. And still get a really long life tire. This farmer told me this morning that he only got 1 year out of the rubber tire. And he's probably gonna get 5 to 10 years out of urethane tire. So what do you got here?
That's just magnet to retrieve lost nuts that dropped down on there.
So if you lose a nut, you can retrieve it?
Yep.
This is the nut retrieval tool. Let's test it. Doesn't work.
Well, I started the nuts already.
Okay. I knew that. I thought you maybe had some antenna for your radio or something here.
Yeah.
So how does it feel to be back at Red E again?
Well, good. I hadn't really planned on assembling wheels when I came back, but whatever. True.
He's trying to do our bathroom remodel, or new bathroom in the office, but we said, Mayday, we need some wheels assembled. This guy's already been waiting for a few weeks, so we gotta get this done and shipped out. So I'm gonna probably get a lot of requests for this awesome press that I designed like 5+ years ago. Let's just say it's too expensive. Unless you're gonna do a lot of these wheels, you're not gonna wanna pay the money, but it is amazing.
Look at that. Got a few stainless orders on the floor. We're just waiting on, guess what? Funnel weldments.
So good thing those are in process over there because we got to get those out of here. Looks like some of these other things might be waiting on one thing or another. That's just really holding us up. Like a lot of these are 95, 99% complete, but we're waiting on one thing or two things. And it's just, it's a daily battle, guys. So we do apologize to you guys who have had to wait a little longer than expected, but we're doing our best.
Look how involved these kits are.
We try to do all the work for you so you don't have to worry about all these little parts and things like that. It all shows up. You guys need an air seater hopper extension? We do tons of those. This looks like a Romafa zone control setup. We finally are getting those in. All right, I better get back to the office and do some invoicing and follow up with customers.
What are you doing?
Lisa's there working hard.
You want some pistachios?
Michaela's working hard, trying to take care of all the phone calls coming in and all the order processing.
Oh, wow. Oh,
Elijah's on the phone. He's always on the phone. Man, Elijah, get off the phone. Just kidding. Get on the phone. We need you on the phone.
Yeah. Can you get that order next air?
Yep. Working on it.
Are you stepping on a meter housing?
I am. This is my stool.
That's the stepladder that you need to see what I'm doing.
Yeah,
now.
True. Now I can see you.
It's a very cheap and inexpensive way to make sure you can check in on
me. Man, Jesse's always eating. Of course, we have accounting activity over here.
Morning.
Always doing accounting stuff. Need that done too. And one of my favorites, Kelly. Oh,
trick here, thanks.
No, Kelly's our video editor. So he's gonna see this video and he's gonna edit it, hopefully. And then you guys will see it. So we really love having him and he does a great job. Hey guys, comment below if you think he does a great job. We always like the feedback. And we like to hear what else you guys like to see. All right, heading back farther in the depths of our office here. We've got accounts payable, purchasing, Nick here, Jeff.
Okay. All right.
They're doing their job, working hard. Our engineering manager's out, so we won't mention him, Adam. Anyway, we got some engineers out as well because of spring break, but Derek's here. Isaac's over there listening to some tunes. Oh, Derek, he's looking at me. Yep.
Good job.
He's our quality control guy too a lot of times, so got to deal with the issues. All right, printing some manuals. Let me show you guys what I have to work on. Not the most glamorous part of my job.
These are all the invoices I got to do.
I'd say this is a job well done. Good job, Dad.
Thanks for your help.
You are welcome.
Couldn't do it without him a lot of times. Really appreciating him. Hey guys, thanks for watching. Thanks for tracking with us and thanks for supporting your local farmer. If we can be a part of helping you keep on farming with your air seeding equipment, give us a call. We're here to help. And as you can tell, we're really busy, but we're putting in the hours and we're doing what we need to do to get it out the door and get it to you so you can be making the best pass on your most important pass of the year. All right, God bless. Remember, Jesus loves you. Take care. What do you guys think of this gauge wheel press? Pretty cool, huh? Comment below if it's something you'd love to have on your farm. They are really expensive. I definitely over-designed or over-engineered it, but you can see why I did. This thing is for production. It is kind of an in-between a high volume production and maybe a shop use tool, but the coolest thing is it helps keep the wheels true. You really can't, and it really saves on time. So these things are the kind of tools that Ready designs and we come up with every day, things like this, just to help us do our job better and to help you do your job better. All right, out.